How to handle the problems before the problems come. God wants us to fill us every morning, to feed us with the truth. That's why Jesus said in John 8:39, if the Son of God delivers you, you are delivered indeed. Yes, that's why in today's second reading, the Lord tells us, 1 Peter 2:9, you have to write it and keep it on your house. And see, every day he says, you are a chosen generation. You are chosen by God. It is not that you chose him. He found 1, 2, 3, 4. I want only these three. That is called choosing. God has chosen you. This truth has to grow deep into you. You are not simply surviving on this earth. You are not simply thrown away into the world. You are a chosen. And through generation, God has chosen you. He chose Abraham. He chose Isaac, Jacob. And all their blessings came in the person of Jesus. And through Jesus, he has given to all of us. So all the blessings of Abraham, all the blessings of Jesus is given to you. All the generation blessings, what you have not worked, what Abraham earned, is given to you because you are chosen generation. You are the royal priesthood. You have the grace to stand at the altar, to participate in his own body and blood. Yes. We are given that privilege to celebrate him every day in the Holy Eucharist. Yes. He says, we are given the power that with his light, we have to come out of the darkness. Fourth, he says, he has given us so many type of situation. He allows situations which are not favorable to us, that with his presence, we have to tell the world, show the world the power and the love of God who is in us, to be witness for his love. My dear friends, today the Lord is telling us, in Christ, every challenge shows God's faithfulness. Every challenge gives us new possibilities. Every challenge shows us how God is faithful to us. It gives us new possibilities. Okay, this is the problem. This is the way the Lord wants me. New revelation. I have the problem. I invite the Lord. And through the Lord, I find new ways how God wants me to handle it. Yes, our God shows us the way where there is no way. Sometimes the situation will be so horrible. A young girl told me, who is working in Kutch Pauli, the markings that is needed for her promotion was not given. She did not want to talk to her boss because her boss is not approachable. But what did she do? She went to the Lord and said, Daddy, I'm your daughter. You know how faithfully I have lived and I work hard and the world has not recognized me. But please, I surrender to you. You know what is best, Daddy. If it is your will, give me the promotion this year and the increment that is needed for me. And if this is your will that I have to remain in this position, I surrender to you, Daddy, because you know the best. The girl is saying, Father, do you know? She is teaching me. I said, I understand, daughter, because I also need people like you sharing your faith. She says, Father, I prayed 8:00 and I was resting just half an hour. Phone call came. First time my boss is calling me. I was shocked. I sat on my bed. I said, what, sir? You are calling me, sir. You could have told me, sir. I would have called you. No, ma. Are you disturbed that your promotion is not there? I too felt. I saw the list. I know that you may be disturbed. Don't worry, I will do the needful. Within 2 days, he did more than what I expected. My dear friends, we all go through problem. We need to just put our plug into the Lord. And then God will begin to operate in us. The problem with us is we always held up and stuck up with our problem. And we allow the problem to rule us. The problem to dictate our thoughts. To pull us like the child throwing away the food. Pulling down the dress. Crying and weeping. My dear friends, life is full of challenges. This world is meant for people who are willing to take challenges. This world is meant for people who follow Jesus Christ, who carried the cross, who died on the cross, who brought salvation out of the cross. The whole world said cross means a cursed instrument. But God, Jesus Christ, transformed the so-called cursed instrument into instrument of blessing. Today, cross is an instrument of blessing. It is kept on every hospitals. My dear friends, take care. Life is a challenge. Yes, don't get upset. Don't allow your problem to ruin you. That's why today the Lord is saying, you are the chosen race, chosen generation. You are mine. And the Lord is telling, God will turn everything into good for those who trust in Him. That's what we read in Romans 8:28. Hold on to that. Yes. The word of God says, when the problem came, in the first reading we find there were apostles, and 3,000 people, then 5,000 people, so many people have joined together, and crowd is increasing, and the problems, suddenly new problems are coming. The women who are not Jews, they are coming and telling, we are widows, so we are not given proper food, we are not given enough bread. New problems, there is so much partiality. On the one hand, the apostles and others are filled with the Holy Spirit. They are going around preaching. Anointing is there. So many people are joining. Suddenly, new problems to put off what God is doing. We have to be alert. If any problem comes, means the enemy is angry that God is doing something in you. God is going to do something great in you. Always I say, only the trees that have the fruits will have the stones. Because your problem, don't get upset. The word of God says, when the disciples, the church is growing, new problems, a big problem. What is that? Partiality, groupism, division. All these things the enemy has brought. People have come to know the truth. Jesus is the Savior, but now they had some problem. My dear friends, when we follow the Lord, definitely there will be problems. We are not in heaven, we are in the world. Seeing the problems, don't get upset. In Christ Jesus, every challenge shows God's faithfulness. 1 Thessalonians 5:24. Every challenge along with Christ will lead us to new possibilities, new strength, new ways through which to handle the problems. Our God will turn everything into good. So what did he do? Because of this problem, God raised up 7 men who are full of the Holy Spirit and who live a righteous life. Yes, any problem comes and the solution comes when you are filled with the Holy Spirit. When you live a righteous life, let anything happen. I will live what is right. I will live as what is right according to the Lord. You stand up, God will raise you up. And God raised up 7 people like Saint Stephen, Saint Philip and so on. Big people. Yes. Throughout of the problem, God raised up saints. In your life, are there problems? When you stand with the Lord, from you, your children will rise up. When you have the problem, you start to kneel down and cry, your children will see. What you are holding on to God and confessing your faith, and you are telling your children, don't worry, as this problem is there, our daddy is there with us. Come on, let's praise God. Daddy, you are our father, you are our God, and you are with us. When you begin to confess, today you confess, tomorrow your child will confess the same.